one of the biggest questions we get at back to school night is from parents that just want to help their child. They want to do what's best for their child. And when their child is struggling, especially with homework, they want to jump in. And so they'll ask, what am I supposed to do?
So helping students, your children with homework can really be a little tricky. You don't want to do the homework for them. And sometimes it can be really tempting because I know I'm pulling my hair out at the end of the night sometimes. But the more you can do to support your children by helping them be the thinkers, them go through the mathematics, the better off they're going to be.
Engage your children in conversation, ask them about it, ask them to explain their thinking. When you start to dig deeper and when you start to ask them questions, it's really not a lot different than what we learned as children. You just see it represented in different ways. And the reason we're having them represented in different ways is so they get that deeper conceptual understanding and they're better prepared for the more challenging and advanced mathematics that are going to be offered to them as they grow in school.
What parents need to think about when they think about homework is opportunities for their students to show, share, and express and do some of the types of problems that they've learned in class. And a parent needs to be willing to say, I know how to do it this way, and I can get the right answer. My son or daughter can do the problem this way. Let me have them explain to me what their thinking is.
In my own district, one of the things we've done over the past year is we've developed what's called the Howard County Public School System Family Math Support Center. And essentially what it is it's an online resource that was built collaboratively with teachers and parents and community members all providing input into sort of what was needed, you know, right now. So there are three major goals behind the Family Math Support Center. One is to provide families with a better sense of what kids are learning in their mathematics course or in the grade level that they're in. The second goal is to help families understand new or maybe unfamiliar mathematics concepts. And the third goal is for kids that maybe need remediation or intensification or even enrichment, what we've done is we've provided additional practice, you know, for students.
And I think it's really important for that connection with the teacher to really make sure that as a parent you're spending time talking with the teacher, finding out what's happening in the classroom, you know, what do they see as the way that you can support your child, and that our messaging about, you know, well, I didn't do good math or some aren't doing good math can really make a difference. And so if you're really making every effort to share with your child that you can do it, if you work hard and that you don't give up, you can learn math or anything.
If you stay with them every step of the way and they walk through math, I believe we'll have more students also be successful in mathematics. New standards or not, I think that part as a parent or as a grandparent, as a guardian, being there with them every step of the way to say, you can do it, keep going, you can do it, keep going. And providing that opportunity, that space, and that support is probably as important as what the teacher might be doing in the classroom every day.
The parent needs to step back and think about, how can I help my child move forward? How can I help my child do the thinking? What questions can I ask my child that might help them?
And one of the things that we do know from the research literature is that the two things that matter most when it comes to mathematics learning is, number one, having rigorous mathematical tasks to work on, and number two, having opportunities to talk about your mathematical thinking. So if parents can be there to help their children talk about their mathematical thinking, it contributes to their learning, and it also helps prepare them for any kind of discussion they're going to have in the classroom the next day about that work.
When parents have a question about a homework assignment, the first thing I would say they ought to do is go talk to the child's teacher. I mean, I think most of us in this profession love when parents come to us with a question about the curriculum. I think it gives us an opportunity to share with those families what we're doing, why we're doing it, and talk a little bit about how their kids' learning is happening.
So parents, of course, as the kids' first teachers, can do a lot to develop early math skills. A lot of parents do this very naturally. You know, we count going up the stairs and coming down the stairs, and we notice numerals in when we're shopping with kids and the like. Kids are motivated by mathematics. They're interested in mathematics. They're interested in seeing the world through mathematical eyes.
That is an extremely important point, the idea that parents need to have positive attitudes about mathematics with their children, even if they themselves didn't like mathematics or didn't feel good at mathematics.
And so teaching kids that their brain is is changeable, that intelligence is something that can grow, that math knowledge is something they can develop with hard work. There's an empowerment piece to it as well, particularly for students who have struggled for a long time.
We have to move away from the attitude that it's all about inherent ability or aptitude, and recognize that with good instruction, with good support, and with proper motivation, people can master anything they want. It's a question of whether they're encouraged to do that.
I think one of the strongest messages I would ask parents to send their students is, well, how about this? The message not to send your student is, oh, that's math. I could never do math either. I'm not going to be able to help you. Or I can see why you're having trouble because I never could do it. The truth is, folks, there is no math gene. It's not about something you inherit. And so the strongest message parents can send is, yes, you can do it. Yes, I'm excited about you learning math. And even if you're not at the same level that your students eventually reach, that's okay. Let them go beyond you. Let's expect that they will. Won't it be wonderful if all of our children can succeed even beyond what we can? Let's send the message that helps them do that.